sì, lo so che luce, luce in una stanza quando manca il sole. Se non ci sei tu con me, con me, sì. Le finestre mostrano tutto il mio cuore che è acceso. Chiudi dentro me la luce che hai incontrato per strada.
You're looking at all the tiggy biggy diggy diggy doggy. Doogie doogie pookie pookie wookie doogie rookie mookie snooky. Say what you say, D-Bobby. Rain today. Who? Para tu. A para pi. And a saga matata. Ma. I am Bamba. Oh, son Teddy. Adam Travis Pastrana. Time to say goodbye. Yo no lo papu. Remamos ta. Jambande Adidu.
That was good. Sara, it's time to say goodbye to the cruise room.
Bye-bye.
So one more thing to do.
Yep.
The Everglades.
said we were like it was at. Oh. I said it was like we're at the races, and what did you say?
It's about to take off.
Yeah. Because what?
It's an airboat.
Is it? What kind of bird was that?
That's a falcon that went by.
Really? Do you want one?
No.
Why?
Because I respect their distance.
Why?
Because they can bite you pretty good.
Hey, but you love birds.
I'm not like a, I don't know what it is. People who train falcons like to have those big fancy clothes.
Bird whisper.
No. There's like a specific
pizza
name.
Maker. Sara? Yeah. We're going on an airboat ride. Gonna fly home.
All right, everybody.
Hello.
Nothing says Christmas like Michael Bublé. Okay?
Yeah, that
goes for all you old hippies, too. Especially you guys from California.
Especially you.
Maybe you stick your hand in the water, you're more likely to see an alligator.
I say throw this guy overboard. We want to see a lot of them.
Well, we tried for three, we got two. That's better than half, right? Got some iguanas. Beautiful day.
That's like 66.6667%.
Alright, here we go.
That's so bad. Getting blown away. Sara, explain, what's he saying? What?
Excuse me.
Is that the full translation?
Language or anything on that?
How you doing, brother? Yeah, yeah. Woke up this morning like, oh Lord, it's gonna get cold in that water. Now, the way it works. I'm surrounded by it. I wear my sunglasses. You can't see the fear in my eyes. Oh Lord. Alright, are we going that way? Okay.
It's like a clock. Oh, the clock froze.
Hey,
can you translate? See the fox in there?
Hi.
Good day, Nicholas. What'd you find here? Pig or birds. There's more birds than there's pigs.
Are you afraid to go up there?
The most dangerous animal here was the tree. At least to Sara. She just got smacked by the tree. In the face.
I almost got bit in the face.
By a
ferocious,
tree.
Huge, 6-foot alligator.
No.
It was a baby alligator, and it was about 2 feet, almost 2 feet.
He got squirmy.
He got squirmy, but he had tape on his jaw, so I knew I wouldn't get hurt, but it was just, you know, the surprise of him being like,
Was he strong? Or was it just a surprise? Yeah.
Rang my face.
Didn't we go out the wrong way?
I don't fucking know. That's a crappy fish.
You know what I want for dinner?
Crap.
I want a piece of crappy fish.
What we're gonna do here is
wildlife. Here we see the wild flower truck, one of the most dangerous animals in Florida. It's like ordering food at Taco Bell. Wow, look how big their oranges are.
Thanks and ancient guests. But they did retire here.
What the heck is that? It's a dove. The turtle dove. Hey, look, Sara. We should get our picture there.
The first one there is like a yellow spider, but the next one, you know, that's a night heron. They usually do their fishing at night. And there's a big one right there. That's a black eyed night heron right there. Can you see him up there?
Stop.
It's kind of grayish black wings. They get active at night. They make noise. You turn the light at night.
Lord of the Rings shot. Sarah, what are we looking at?
We're looking for the Florida Panther, which is basically a mountain lion.
Florida Panther? I think somebody put their boobs right up against the... Sarah, look right behind you. The water reminds me of the Love Boat ride in Left 4 Dead. So one thing that's kind of unfortunate to see is how discrimination continues to prevail here in Florida. Like, it's just wrong. Oh, there he is. The alligator. Oh, he's gone.
His feet. Look at his arms. Look at his face. Look at his hairdo.
You want to pet him?
No.
You're good. That was the right answer. Oh, you pissed it off. How do you know? How do you know that's what they want?
They want you to spend 25 cents.
Oh. Wow, these guys are harder salesmen than the ones in the Caribbean. Look at them pressure us. Aye. Freshwater turtles. Whoa! Hi. I love how active these guys are. Oh yeah. Ah, oh, he's posing. Here comes another shot for you. I think this is the spot, right? Hi. Whoa. See, I don't even see them coming. They just end up in front of me. Oh my gosh. I want one.
Me too. Whoosh.
Now wait a minute.
Oh, there he is.
That's how I go down slides. This is just a bunch of show-offs. That's all they are. Sarah, look, a wild golf cart. Did you see it? That is a massive pile of shit. Was it you? Enough, it was actually ice. It snowed in Florida. We're gonna get pooped on in the aviary. No. Be honest with me, Sarah. No?
It's been tend to in an aviary before and we haven't been pooped on.
Right, that's why I'm feeling like the odds are starting to climb against me here. Said it yourself. Birds smell because they poop. Like how like some of these birds are just like very okay with what's going on. Just like, eh.
They're used to it.
Sarah, it's doing the mating call for you.
Thank you.
Hey, we found where they keep them. Oh, yeah.
Cornelius.
Show us more of that tongue, oh boy. Yeah. And here we see a natural cell tower discovered in the 1700s. I'm gonna take this home. Keep it.
Frame it.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, now we got dinner, or I do. I'm gonna eat my souvenir.
Then you're gonna eat my souvenir.
If you insist.
Sara, explain.
He drank a lot of water.
Like, how much?
Pitcher at Chili's, and then a whole big bottle at Starbucks with emergency in it. But I did that too.
Well, I guess I didn't drink as much at Chili's because I knew I was gonna drink at
and you didn't
Starbucks.
Eat as much at Chili's.
Yeah.
But that last cup of water just, oh, it was so over the top, it's not even funny. Yeah. I am in such a weird physical state. I feel like I want to do nothing more than pee, but I can't. Why have you done this to me?
I didn't do anything.
You chose the food you wanted to eat. You knew that you wanted to get a thing at Starbucks to put your emergency in.
You sound like my wife. Watch, I'm gonna have to pee the second we take off. The second we take off. And they're gonna say, sorry, there's turbulence for all 6 hours. All right. You have just been out of control.
The neighbor watching.
I'm just pointing out our neighbor. They're gone now, but I didn't touch their screen.
They're watching Zootopia.
Now, did I give him a subliminal message? Maybe.
Sara, you do realize
that with a 6 hour flight, I can watch this movie 3.5 times. And I'm good. Some of us are lighter packers than others. You know, you just need the essentials, right? Just bring what you need. Somebody checked a bottle of lotion. I need to learn to pack lighter. Some people want a really comfortable sleep on their flight. If that's the case, just bring your own mattress. It's like a cot. What the hell is that? If Gumby was a real life-size person, that would have been Gumby.
Murdered.
Dead. Or sleeping, traveling cheap. Sara? That was a honeymoon. That was a pretty good honeymoon. How would you describe our honeymoon in one word?
Excellent.
I would say it was perfect. It was great. So we started at Walt Disney World. How did you think that all went?
It feels so long ago now.
It really does.
I loved Walt Disney World. I had a lot of fun, and we did really good with rides and getting on everything that we really wanted to get on.
Yeah. Yeah. We kind of scheduled things in advance, not really knowing much about Disney World or places to eat. We had some insider info, but as far as like our own personal experience about what we wanted to do. And on top of that, you know, we were like, well, it probably would make sense to do 2 days at these parks instead of, you know, 1 day at these parks. And all that just seemed to really work out.
Yeah.
Really work out. So that was, was great. Now, we walked how many miles?
Like 45, something like that.
About 45 miles, I think over 45 miles of walking at Disney World over 6 days. So by the time we got on the cruise, we were ready for sleep. So, And we did a lot of that. I mean, we slept a lot on this cruise. Holy, I don't think...
It's so hard not to sleep too much, especially when you're in the interstate rooms.
Yes.
Because it's pitch black. No matter what time of day it is, when you turn off those lights, it's pitch black. And
yeah.
You just sleep forever.
It's like putting a blanket over the birdcage. Like, the birds are like, I don't know what they're talking about. The sun ain't up.
Yeah.
Like, it... Yeah, your body is just like, nope, nope. So if you don't set an alarm, you could legitimately wake up in the afternoon and still be convinced it's morning. But Sarah, how was the cruise?
It was good. 10 days. We went to the Caribbean. We went to St. Thomas, St. Kitts, Barbados, and St. Lucia. We tried to go to Princess Keys, but there was weather problems with that one.
Too much wind.
Yeah.
But so, last time we saw you on your first cruise, which was when we went to Hawaii.
Yes.
I'd say one of the bigger storylines from that one was the dessert.
Yeah.
And let's just say the food in general for you, because they were limited on side options. And they were limited on, big time, on desserts for you. How did they do this time?
They did very good this time. They have a new system in place in which you order 24 hours in advance. So when I went to go eat dinner the very first night, they accommodated me as best as they could, and they did a very good job. But then they give you the dinner menu for the next day. So then you can make your selections, and the chef will have plenty of time to figure things out and how to best accommodate you. And this also translates to desserts.
Yes.
Desserts are chef's choice. It is whatever he can, you know, come up with that day.
Mm-hmm.
But they were all delicious.
And all different.
All different. I got a little nervous at first because, like, the first two nights there was just like a
tarts,
like they were tart cakes or something like that. Like, it was like a strawberry one, yeah, and I think a lemon one.
Yeah.
And I'm like, uh-oh, are they all gonna be tart? But then the next dessert that I had, I think, was like a chocolate mousse sort of thing that was gluten and lactose free.
And you made all the women around you jealous. They're like, can we get that? And the waiter's like, actually, no, you can't.
No, it's for allergy friendly.
Yeah.
Food was very good this time. And they, you know, you get to know the head waiter, because he's the one that's like making sure that everything's safe and all that stuff. So that was good.
Yeah. Now I'm going to hop back a little bit to Disney World. Name me a couple of highlights from Disney World.
A couple of highlights. This will sound bad, but getting rained out of Fantasmic was actually a highlight, because it was such a weird situation.
It was
in which,
so
like,
ridiculously.
It was like teetering on the edge of like, oh, is it not, or is it? We gonna go? And like literally right as soon as they're like, Fantasmic will stop in 5 minutes, and everybody's like, really? Because it's been sprinkling the whole damn time that we've been sitting at the stadium. And then like literally right after that is, ladies and gentlemen, I'm very sorry, but we have to cancel tonight's performance because of weather. Because literally after that 5 minute announcement, the heavens just dropped.
Released.
Like, they just released everything, and it started raining really hard, and the stands started to flood, so like you can't even, you know, your shoes are all wet. We had ponchos and we had an umbrella, but that still wasn't enough to keep us completely dry.
No, and also they have a rule against umbrellas, which was
funny
too.
Yeah, they did. So we only used our ponchos. The rule with umbrellas is only for in the stands, because they don't want you blocking the view of the people in front of you.
Just
keep unplugging my thing.
I keep unplugging it, actually. Now, that was a highlight that we didn't get a lot of footage of, because the GoPro that I brought that day apparently like stayed on overnight,
and I wasn't able to get it to turn on. So I wasn't able to really show what was happening during this.
Streets were flooding. It was at Hollywood Studios, like all the streets, like the, what, Sunset Boulevard was it?
Yes, which smelled nothing like the real Sunset Boulevard.
I think another highlight was finally being able to go on Expedition Everest, and we went on it 3 times.
Yeah, because we didn't know if we were going to be able to go on it at all.
Because it broke down like 3 times that that day.
Yeah.
And we got to go on it, and we went on it 3 times, because I knew it was going to be a ride that Jeffrey would really enjoy. And I was like, I really hope that we get to go on this ride, because it kept breaking down whenever we were trying to go on it. And finally, at the end of the day, it stayed in operation for long enough.
There was a funny moment at Hollywood Studios, I think. No, it was actually at... It was at Hollywood Studios. There was a guy who was like, I hate rides that go backwards, or roller coasters that go backwards. And I'm like, what roller coasters do you know that go backwards? Like, I'm like, what is even, how's that even a thing to be worried about?
I was trying to keep it a secret that Expedition Everest went backwards.
Which that didn't spoil it. It was there was another lady who was like, I don't like the backwards pops. And I'm like, what? So, But still, it was a surprise to me because I'd never been on it. So that was cool. You named 2 highlights from 2 different parks. Mm-hmm. Can you name a highlight from Magic Kingdom?
Let's see. I think from Magic Kingdom would be... The one would be guest services, the first lady that we got to see. Like, she hooked us up.
Yeah, she did.
She gave us, we explained to her, hey, we want honeymoon pins. And she's like, oh, happy honeymoon. And she asked for my, card. She put 2 free fast passes to use for anything on there. And that really helped us get all the rides that we wanted. And then another highlight would be the VR guest.
Yeah. Yeah. And then, so that leads us to Epcot. Any highlights from there?
Epcot. Let's see. Anything that stands out from Epcot?
The highlight for you from Epcot had to have been Mission Space.
No. That was Orange. Low light.
Oh, low light.
Yeah. Highlight for Epcot would probably be just experiencing the World Showcase again, and also the show that they put on the lake at the end of the night. It's a good one.
I should probably think of highlights from each one.
And then Animal Kingdom, when you got your character, we got our caricature.
Oh, you like that too? Yeah. That's what I was gonna say. Animal Kingdom was the caricature for sure. Getting us Zootopified.
Yeah. We'll show you that later.
Oh, they've seen it by now.
Oh yeah, they did. Duh.
This is another weird highlight, but taking advantage of the rain in Hollywood Studios. Like she said, it rained that night at Fantasmic, but also rained during the day. And we all had to like huddle underneath this tent, which was where the guy was trying to like sell timeshares. And so there's like 40 people under this tent for like 5 people. And he's like, well, while I have you all here, I'm gonna talk to you about timeshares. And it was just funny. It was a good moment. But I think the bigger highlight for me was Sara enjoying Rock and Roller Coaster. Like, I was like, yeah, and we went on it twice.
Yeah.
So that was great. I love that.
I feel like it's going to be weird when I tell people that know that I hate roller coasters that I enjoyed Rock and Roller Coaster.
Yeah.
But it's actually, it's a lot, it's more mild than the California Screamin', a.k.a. the Incredicoaster nowadays. It's more mild because I hate the drop part of it. Like, the first few seconds of Rock and Roller Coaster suck because it still gives you that kind of feeling in your stomach when it launches you, but it's so quick, it's done so quick, and then the rest of the ride is just not anything that I don't like. I'm fine with going upside down.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Let's see, Epcot. You know, she's gonna hate me for this.
But I think one of my highlights at Epcot was her on Mission's face. I've never heard her make the noises she made that day. Like, I mean, actually, let me rephrase this. The highlight wasn't during the ride. The highlight was after when she got off and I knew, like, okay, she didn't die. Mm-hmm. Because I was like, I'm like, she's either going to die or kill me.
I cried both on the ride and when we got off. Yeah. Because I think I just had a big relief of being finally out of that ride that I was just like...
You did. You cried. Oh man, the screams that she did. You know, like, for anyone that's been on the ride, I'm pretty sure people on the opposite side of the ride heard her screaming.
I liked your description of what, like, the ride operators probably heard was because it spins.
Epcot, the dinner that we did. That was cool. That was really cool. Yeah. Eating with the fishes and hearing a little girl yell shark every time a shark went
shark!
By.
Shark!
The scene went by like every 45 seconds.
Shark!
Hiding the plate of bacon from Piglet was pretty funny. Yeah. Also that random hey Peter moment with Peter Pan being like, hey! I was like, Peter. But overall, just for me, the highlight, I think, of all of Disney World was just how well-timed everything was. Like, I was like, wow, we really made this work. Yeah. Then we got to the cruise. Highlights on the cruise for you?
Relaxing after sleeping. 45 miles worth of walking at Disney World. Yeah, I mean, I enjoyed the islands. I really enjoyed ziplining.
Yeah, was that your favorite excursion?
Yeah.
Yeah, zip lining was a lot of fun.
Yeah.
I also enjoyed getting able to just swim in the ocean. People don't understand, this girl will not touch the Pacific Ocean.
No.
Too cold.
Too cold.
So to see her swimming in the ocean for me was like, oh my
God. Number one, I'm not a big beach person, and then number two, it's just too cold. The monkey.
Yeah.
The monkey that I got to hold twice.
The food, man. I love... So cruising for me has always been one of my favorite forms of vacationing. I fell in love with it when I was younger. First cruise I did, I think it was 13. I've been on a number of cruises with my family, and I haven't been on one. This was the longest stretch I had gone, not going on a cruise since I started cruising. And it was, yeah, Hawaii was the last time we went on a cruise, so.
Or like 6 or 7 years for you?
Six years. Yep. And I've been missing it a lot. Really missing it. I haven't really done a vacation since I started working back in 2014. So this was really cool. Just to be able to go relax. And it's funny too, because I know there were a number of people who were like, oh, don't film your honeymoon because that's for you and her. But I'm like, who of you actually thought I was gonna go on a vacation and not have a camera attached to my hand? Mm. That's not how it goes. That's not how I do it.
Come on, guys.
Come on, guys.
You don't need to white knight me. I already knew that he was gonna like film this thing, and I'm like, do it.
Yeah. So no, it was awesome, and you know, for me, the filming of it is a big part. Just so I can look back at it. We can look back at it, see the memories and everything. But it's fun to share. Like, you know, I mean, why not? Like, to me, I enjoy making the stuff and putting it together. I'm gonna edit it the way I'm gonna edit it anyways. Might as well post some stuff. So, yeah, it was awesome. It was a lot of fun. Any last words?
No.
No.
Goodbye.
Yeah. I have three last words.
I want to say another highlight, but it was on the cruise.
Okay.
this is going to be a little self-serving, but I liked the joke that I made when you were like talking about Beast being a furry or whatever.
That was pretty great.
And I burned that joke about Mel being like, fuck, I just gotta do it.
Oh, another highlight was watching Beast tail fall off.
Yeah.
That was excellent. With that, Sarah, all I gotta say is happy honeymoon, and I love all the food that I ate on this cruise. It was so good.
I love you too.
I love you. Well, thanks for watching, guys. We have a 6-hour flight to get home. And then it's back to what some refer to the real world, but I don't live in that, so. Yeah, see y'all around. I hope you had fun. Because I know we did. Bye.